message for you to help you get settled in on your first night. I actually worked in that office before you and finished up my last week now, as a matter of fact. So I know it can be a bit overwhelming, but I'm here to tell you there's nothing to worry about. You'll do fine. So let's just focus on getting you through your first week, okay? Let's see here. There's an introductory greeting from the company that I'm supposed to read. It's kind of a legal thing, you know. Okay. Welcome to Medi's Igloo Rental, a magical place for kids and grown-ups alike, where fantasy and fun come to life. Medi's Igloo Rental is not responsible for damage to property or person. Upon discovering that damage or death has occurred, a missing person report will be filed within 90 days, or as soon as property and premises have been thoroughly cleaned and bleached and the carpets have been replaced. Blah, blah, blah. Now, I know that might sound bad, I know, but there's really nothing to worry about. The animatronic character here does get a bit quirky at night, but do I blame him? No. If I were forced to sing those same stupid songs for 20 years and I never got a bath, I'd probably be a bit irritable at night, too. So, remember, this character holds a special place in the hearts of children, and we need to show them a little respect, right? Okay. So just be aware, Medi does tend to wander a bit. He's left in some kind of free roam mode at night. Something about his servos locking up if they get turned off for too long. They used to be allowed to walk during the day, too, but then there was the 6 pages of 21. It's amazing that the frontal lobe can keep that many no-no words in it, you know? Now, concerning your safety, the only real risk to you as a night watchman here, if any, is the fact that this character, well, if he happens to see you after hours, probably won't recognize you as a person. He'll most likely see you as a metal endoskeleton without its costume on. Now, since that's against the rules here at Medi's Igloo Rental, they'll probably try to forcefully stuff you inside a penguin suit. Now, that wouldn't be so bad if the suits themselves weren't filled with crossbeams, wires, and animatronic devices, especially around the facial area, so you could imagine if having your head forcefully pressed inside one of those could cause a bit of discomfort and death. The only parts of you that would see the light of day again would be your eyeballs and teeth when they pop out the front of the mask. Yeah, they don't tell you these things when you sign up. But, hey, the first day should be a breeze. I'll chat with you tomorrow. Check those cameras, and remember to close the doors only if absolutely necessary. Gotta conserve power. Alright, good night.
Sure.